Do you know what the number one question I get asked as a real estate agent in Wise County? How's the market? I'm going to tell you how it is. So I pulled the comps for the past 3 months for all the new construction for like 2019. It was unbelievable how many houses we sold in 3 months new construction. About 49. The average price per square foot was about $141 per square foot. That'll get you a house on either 1 acre or 2 acres. And I want to tell you one thing that might make it hard to sell a house that is not new construction. So with all that new construction, one thing that hurts is the homes that are built in the late 80s, early 90s, or even early 2000s. You're up against new construction in Wise County. You can go and get a brand new build on 2 acres or 1 acre for $140 a foot, or you can go and get a 1980s or 1990s house that needs some updates. Every light fixture, every light switch, all the can lights are yellow from being faded from the sun. That's what you're up against. So if you are a seller that is trying to sell a 1980s, 2000s range home, you're up against a lot of competition. The competition is brand new construction. Somebody can move in and just move in that day. Well, if they're gonna buy your older home, there's nothing wrong with it. Same square footage. It is a nice home. It's functioning to its intended purpose. The only thing that it is a couple that moves in can move right in and not have to update. So where does that factor in with the older homes? I don't think you can compete with the new construction price per square foot. Price per square foot here for new construction, older homes, people are trying to get the new construction prices. It's not working. Average days on the market for the older homes, they're sitting. It's sitting too long. Well, what does that mean? When somebody does bring you an offer, you've sat on the market for too long trying to compete with the new construction, they're gonna offer you much less. You will end up taking less for your home or not sell it at all, because you're trying to compete with new construction comps. The name of the game right now is new construction. We have to get the price per square foot down on the older homes in order to compete with the price of the new construction homes. One other thing that I noticed was that the homes that I had for sale that were over $400,000 this summer, those were really tough sells. They were on larger acreage, some of them on 10, some of them even 4 or even 3. That really doesn't matter to some people that do not want to take care of or mow 2+ acres. So yes, you're trying to get some more money for those extra acreages, but you're still competing against those new constructions that are only 2 acres and under. That's less maintenance. So the market share for more acreage actually goes down quite a bit. It is harder to sell something on more acreage because less people want to take care of that acreage actually around here. So things are changing in this county a little bit. Everybody's liking that 2 acres and maybe nothing more than that. But that is your competition. Some people want it. They want FFA animals. They want 4-H animals on that larger acreage. We have those, but those prices may need to come down just a little bit to get them sold. The third thing I get asked about a lot on how's the market, is there any land available? Can I buy 2 acres without any deed restrictions? Is there even 10 acres in Decatur or Wise County? That's a hard thing to come by. A lot of the 2-acre tracts of land are being developed by either a builder developer or a developer, and he is wanting to sell those to the spec home builders because those spec home builders want to buy that 2-acre lot for the inventory to be able to build a new construction house on. So they don't really care what the price is. They just need the land to build a house on. They make the money on the build job. They make the margins on the build. So it is hard to come by just random 2 acres that are not deed restricted to a certain type of house or a certain location on the property. Very hard to come by, especially in Decatur. A lot of the builders are buying those 2 acres. So finding just random 2 acres of land is difficult in Wise County. Now go up to 10 acres, I can help you with that, but that might have to get you north of Decatur. North of Decatur, Alvord, Sunset, somewhere around Greenwood or up down to 51 North. Those are beautiful places, but the price per acre for 10 acres is skyrocketing. That is such a desirable location. The demand is wanting it, so the price is going up, and there's comps, they're selling things, or things are selling to drive those comps up. So what do I see 10 acres going for in north of Decatur in Wise County? You're gonna be around $200,000 for 10 acres consistently for the next year or so. Now, that is kind of alarming because when you buy 10 acres and then you build a $250,000 or $300,000 house on top of that $200,000 for 10 acres, you're at $500,000 for a piece of property. Is that property really worth $500,000? It depends on how bad you want your family to live on 10 acres in a nice house. Do I think you can sell it right away? I'm not sure right now, but as time goes by, as the market demand comes this way, I think it'll be okay, but that's a tough one to swallow at $500,000. All those pigeons up here. There's one thing about the county seat of Wise, that's Decatur's courthouse. This county's thriving, it's doing really good. The real estate market's doing well. The economic development properties is going well. I think we're gonna do okay for the next 5 years. I'm really excited about that. There's a lot of change coming and it's for the better. If you wanna be a part of this community or kind of be involved, reach out to me. I'm gonna be the president of the Decatur Chamber of Commerce for 2020. And I'm super excited about that, but I want more involvement. I want people like you to come to me so you can find ways to be involved in the community. You can't make this place even better if you don't get involved. No complaining unless you're involved.